Ah, Peppa Pig. The lovable cartoon worth over $1 billion. In fact, did you know that the voice actor of Peppa Pig, Harley Bird, earns over $1,000 per hour? That's insane. I wish I had her job. Hey everyone, welcome back to Most Amazing Top 10, and welcome to today's video. I'm your host, Lindsay Ivan, and today I'm gonna share with you the top 10 times Peppa Pig ruined your childhood. So, Peppa Pig is a show that thousands of kids worldwide watch. Probably a show that defined a lot of children's childhood. So, if you don't want your memories of Peppa to be tainted, I suggest you not watch this video. So, Peppa Pig, for those of you who don't know, is a British animated show that follows the life of Peppa, a little preschool-aged pig. Seems completely harmless, but I'll be telling you otherwise. Starting off this countdown, we have foul language. So, Peppa is known to be fairly sassy. She definitely has an attitude problem, but at least the show doesn't use bad language, right? Well, parents were saying that the show actually taught their children to swear. So, a mother claims that after watching a particular episode, her daughter regularly used the F word. She learned this from the episode titled End of Term Party. During this episode, the characters are talking about Peppa's school teacher, Madame Gazelle, and her past as a guitarist in a band. Grandpa Rabbit then says the line, "Ah, that's right, she played the guitar with the Rocking Gazelles." But it sounds like he says the effing gazelles. What's worse is that people then made parody videos where they dub over the cartoon and make them swear and say inappropriate things. It shows Peppa cussing out her parents and friends and making lewd comments, completely ruining the show. Moving on at number 9, we have the adult jokes. So, there are tons of children movies and shows that have jokes specifically for the adult audiences that are often forced to watch alongside their child. It is shown that Peppa Pig does this as well. So, in one episode, Freddy the Fox is talking to his dad and he says, "I've just had my dinner down a rabbit hole." No explanation needed. In the episode called Shake, Rattle, and Bang, the children are trying out musical instruments for the first time. As a result, they are all playing them and making a lot of noise. That's when Madame Gazelle says, "Anybody can bang, bang, bang." These are just some of the innuendos that people have found. If you knew what these jokes meant as a child, then it definitely would have changed your perspective on the show. In our 8th spot, we have fat shaming. There are countless episodes where Peppa is seen making fun of her dad's appearance for being more plump than the others. She's constantly making snarky remarks about her dad's weight and stomach, which you can see upsets her father. So, how is this going to impact developing children? They're literally going to think that fat shaming is acceptable. So, here are some examples. In one episode, Peppa is in her treehouse. Her dad asks to come in, but Peppa will only let him in with the secret word, which is Daddy's big tummy. In another episode, her dad wants to go down the slide, but Peppa says, "Daddy, you're too big to go down the slide." When he gets stuck halfway on the slide, she laughs. Her dad is embarrassed and says, "It's not funny." She replies with, "It looks very funny, Daddy." And then you have the episode where Peppa needs a partner for a race. Her dad is so excited to be her partner, but Peppa bluntly says that he sucks at running. There are way more examples of her just being rude to her dad, saying he doesn't look fit or his tummy is too big. How is that going to make kids feel if they end up being bullied like this for their weight? Coming in at number 7, we have ageism. In Peppa Pig, there are multiple times where the show pokes fun at someone's old age. It seems like they're shaming the older characters and discriminating against them because of their age. So, in the episode titled Granny and Grandpa's Attic, Peppa asks her grandpa what an attic is. Her grandpa replies with, "It's where we keep all our old things." Then Peppa says, "Like you, Grandpa Pig?" And in another episode, it's her dad's birthday and he's about to blow out the candles on his cake. That's when he says, "Wow, there's a lot of candles." And Peppa replies with, "That's because you're really old, Daddy." Now, these seem like innocent little jokes, but honestly, ageism is a very serious issue and can have negative effects on the elderly. For our 6th spot, we have the Peppa effect. With Peppa Pig's increasing popularity, there are tons of children across the world watching it, meaning there are tons of children being influenced by the show. Reports say that children who watched the show started to copy Peppa's behavior. This includes having a slight British accent and even snorting. But this means that kids were also picking up her disrespectful behavior. They called this influence the Peppa effect. Peppa is shown to be rude to her parents and friends. In fact, she even says things like, "I don't like you anymore, you're not my best friend." So, parents reported saying that kids were being more defiant and having bad attitudes after watching the show. A research study also proved that their show was making kids lose their capability of developing empathy. So, yeah, kids were literally turning into Peppa. We are now at our fifth and halfway mark with the horror episodes. So, Peppa the Pig isn't a scary show at all. It's brightly colored and lighthearted. However, there are individuals out there that have made their own episodes. Well, have completely taken away the innocence of the show. So, in some of these videos, it starts off looking like a normal episode. Then all of a sudden, it's filled with blood and violence. In one episode, Peppa and her brother are being chased around the house by their dad holding a bloody knife. Then they run into the kitchen where they find their mom's head cut up on a plate. In another episode, you have Peppa at the dentist. Her teeth are being pulled out, and then later on, an axe gets wedged in her head. There have been lots of reports of parents letting their kids watch these episodes thinking that they're just from the normal show, only to be horrified when they see the violence. In our fourth spot, we have Peppa's real height. This one shocked me quite a bit when I learned it, but apparently Peppa is 7'1". That's right, she may look like a little pig, but in fact she is a towering monster. That means that all her friends that appear to be around the same height as Peppa are also 7 feet tall. But on the show, Peppa isn't shown to be the tallest character. That means that the adults are even taller than her. In fact, Peppa's dad is a whopping 14 feet tall, and her mom is 11 feet tall. That's horrifying. They literally are mutated giant pigs. Moving on to number three, we have Satanism. So apparently some people believe that satanic messages are hidden inside episodes of Peppa Pig. So first off, pigs are thought to be associated with the devil. There are multiple demons that have taken the form as pigs or demons that have been turned into pigs. Then people claim to have seen a lot of hidden images in the show, like how her flashlight and all the sink taps in her house look like the all-seeing eye, which is often associated with the Illuminati. Then people say that when the characters bring their hands together, it looks like they form horns, looking like devil horns. And lastly, people think that all the pigs' tails look like the number 6. Now, they are often seen together, meaning that if there are 3 pigs, their tails would form 666. They also say that the 666 design was also seen on one of the instruments used during the episode Shake, Rattle, and Bang. So, what do you think? Are people overanalyzing the show and ruining it for others, or what? In our second spot, we have Peppa is a real girl. So, this theory will literally make you look at the show completely differently. So, one person made a theory that Peppa the Pig is based off a real human girl by the same name. They say that Peppa was a young girl that lived an isolated life with mentally unstable parents. She herself had countless medical conditions, including schizophrenia. Her parents would constantly abuse her and call her a pig. This made her convince herself that she actually was one. She would then have imaginary friends, which were animals. One day, Peppa killed her brother George after a fit of rage. As a result, her parents locked her in a basement. Then one day, a man got lost in the woods and stumbled upon Peppa's home. Parents let this man stay the night where he encountered Peppa. As a result, he learned of her story and decided to turn it into a show. But instead of it being a dark show, he gave her the positive, happy life she never had. Coming in at number one, we have Peppa the Cannibal. That's right, Peppa is a pig that loves eating bacon. So in one episode, you can see Peppa eating pizza. However, it looks as if there are slices of pepperoni on it. Or should I say, Peppa. Roni. Now, if that wasn't bad enough, someone decided to make a video about Peppa's cannibalism. So, in the video, Peppa tries bacon for the first time. After that, she becomes obsessed with the taste. She even goes as far as to biting into her dad's stomach and eating it. She ends up attacking and eating her mom as well before trying to get to her brother, but he hides out in the basement. When she has no more pigs to eat, she starts shredding off her own arm skin and eating that. That's just very disgusting and wrong. And that's it for today's video. You know the drill. As always, don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up and comment something down below. And don't forget to hit that bell notification and subscribe to Most Amazing Top 10 for more amazing videos. I've been your host, Lindsay Ivan, and I'll see you when I see you. Grandpa, then people say, I need some water. They also say that the 666, Harry.